And
they're hundreds of miles away, though. They're hundreds and hundreds of miles away. That's not an invasion.
Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN.
All right.
And if you did it well, your ratings would be much better.
Well, that is some of the exchange yesterday between CNN's Jim Acosta and President Trump. By day's end, Jim Acosta had his press credentials, his hard pass, suspended and revoked. And as we sit down and talk to C4, it has been revoked. It is because of a scuffle over a microphone. Look at the actual video. A White House intern who was ordered to do this was attempting to take the microphone away from Jim Acosta. So the next reporter, in that case, Peter Alexander of NBC, was going to take the question. InfoWars decided to edit the video.
Yeah,
and
they doctored a little bit.
Doctored the video to show, and this came from the White House Press Secretary's office, Sarah Sanders. And C4, it shows, they allege, that Jim Acosta, in fact, attacked the intern physically. That did not
that's
happen.
Ridiculous.
All he said was, pardon me, ma'am.
Yeah, but absent that, Robert, I mean, as a professional, first of all, the whole concept of passing a microphone back and forth doing that to me was wrong. They used to have boom mics.
Yes,
where
I know.
The reporters would stand up and they would be recognized by the president and would sit down. But to me, Jim, that was the second or third round of questions, by the way, Jim Acosta had in that particular setting. He should have let the microphone go. Now, is that worthy of having his press credentials yanked? No, it's not. Here's the issue, Robert, that I've said consistently, because Jim Acosta has been going through this with President Trump, and he was candidate Trump throughout the campaign. So it's an ongoing thing, by the way,
candidate Trump and President Trump has done this before to other reporters,
sure.
Starting with Jorge Ramos of Univision right after he
had him ejected. He had one of his security, we call them goons or a couple, one of his security ejected.
And quite honestly, yesterday, the president had one of his goons attempt to stop that.
Well, here's the thing, though, Robert. When it comes to the issue of the president of the United States, he's no longer a candidate. There is some deference. I go back to the days of Helen Thomas, Sam Donaldson. They were aggressive. They were aggressive. They ask tough questions, but a certain level, when the president said move on, you move on. You don't continue exhibiting what I'm telling people.
So then why come up
and
see the anger? No, why come up with doctored video to explain that?
Absolutely. Yes, that's totally wrong. But I'm just saying, though, you lose the moral high ground when you act as the person you're claiming is wrong. A lot of people look at what's going on now with the White House press briefings, whether it's Sarah Sanders or the president, and they see a personal issue that me and the media have, not a professional one, but a personal
animus.
And
I hate making it personal because it's not supposed to be about us.
It shouldn't be. And that's what I'm saying. You can be aggressive, you can be tough, you can be intensive, but you don't need for it to perceive like, I don't like you. I don't like that individual. That's why I go back to the days of Helen Thomas and with
never said, I never liked you, Sam Donaldson.
Exactly. But even
or
if
you
he
should
did,
be fired.
But even if he did, I don't think Sam Donaldson would respond that way. I don't think he would have responded to that type of anger.
See, I would get the sense Sam Donaldson would continue to shout his questions, and President Reagan would pretend not to hear him and then take another question
and
walk off.
And that's why I'm saying you don't yank Jim Acosta's press credentials. We go back to the days when Governor Robert Ehrlich Jr. did the same thing to David Nitkin
and to Michael
Oleska.
And look what happened to him.
And that was wrong. And that's what I'm saying. What you do is you don't answer the question. When they stand up, you don't recognize them. And that's the response the president should have.
All right. We could talk more about this.
Yes, we can.
We've run out of time. C4 back.
Thank you, Robert.
9 to 1 tomorrow on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.